Hello my dear baby flower, and welcome back to UF Watermed, where I am very excited to play this game a little bit more after I have been not playing it for like 2 weeks because I have been busy working getting here. And yeah, probably I will not have that much time playing it here. However, I might be able to continue this playing it here. So let's capture this base here in... I still haven't checked where this is, but we will see very soon once I successfully capture the base. And here I have this flight here chasing this plant over there. Oh yeah, this biomass is spreading very fast. I am 50% finished in the aircraft range, but yeah, I cannot wait to get to the maneuverability, because the range will not... So yeah, the speed seems like, you know, it feels like it, you know, helps out, you know, in the fight too, although it does seem like it also increased our cruise speed too, because our fighters are moving faster on the global map too. So this is both increased our cruising and our top speed too, so it seems like it helps in the battle too, with evading. And the armament definitely helps. The range will not help in the fight. That's quite obvious, that will just enable us to chase the UFO farther away. So yeah. But then we will get the aircraft maneuverability, and that will only help in the battle. But that's what we need. So the range will get us to the range, maneuverability. We already have the control system for it, we just don't have the range. And we didn't have the range yet because we didn't have the fuel sample from the aliens. This needed the engine that we had, and it needed the computers that we had. But up until now we didn't have the fuel, but we do have the control system, and had the control system, but we didn't have the range for it. For this we will need the reticle and everything. For that we will need the second scripted mission too, and then get the Dreamland achieves. Not mistaken with the Dreamland files, which we got from Area 51. We need the Dreamland Archives, and then we can get the report on the Dreamland Archives, and then we can get on with the debriefing of Reticulan Officer. Yeah, which will help us with the biomass growth theory. We need... Oh, we don't need that. We need the aircraft armor for that, yeah. We need the Reticulan Officer for the aircraft armor. Yeah, for the biomass growth we will need the biomass analysis and the Torngenon theory. And we cannot go work on the analysis yet because we have no sample of biomass. But we are working on the Torngenon theory. We will just need a slime thrower, and then we will be able to research this. Yeah, and we got able to learn about this theory, the preliminary, because we got the biomass node material from the downed planter. So yeah, let's go. I am quite excited. Okay. We have saved here of course before. And we successfully loaded. So let's capture this base.
More orders!
There are always more orders.
Your orders, sir.
Okay.
I have orders.
And we don't have our spotter guy. Who was Tim? Jim. Jim was the spotter guy, I think. So we don't have him here. We sent him to failing, which means that now Shorat is our postal guy, but he's also the sniper rifle, so he should not be. And Zinatul is slow, but he is having the best. So yeah, I will have to micromanage this, because Zinatul is our second best spotter. I am not gonna send Shorat forward with the sniper rifle.
I hate it!
Yeah, but Zinatul is also our slowest guy, and he needs to be forward.
Jesus!
Oh, guys. So, we wanna go over there. The entrance is close. Oh, what? You wanna go over there? Why? Oh no, you wanna split into two teams? No, that's not good. Go over there. Oh, you still don't want to give... Oh, this motorbike or something here. Yeah, it's like motorbike. This is blocking our path. Oh, I could try to explode it. Because why would we want to go all the way around? They walk over there and we will try to explode the motorbike.
What is it?
Yeah, you can already shoot at it with the grenade launcher, but I don't want to use the grenade launcher.
I hear you.
Someone who is carrying a normal grenade, like Rick. Well, I guess Ia should do it.
What is your orders, sir?
I hear your orders.
So yeah, let's see if you can destroy that bike there.
What now, sir?
Oh yes! Oh yes! Very good.
What is it?
What is it?
Zinatul, you walk forward.
What now, sir?
What's now, sir? Okay.
You're all
and now, sir. Everyone walk over here. Yeah, Zinatul is so slow. People are catching up. And here, of course, I could blow another way here to the wall, but no, I will just walk over there. Let's just wait up everyone.
What is it?
What it is?
Ready, sir.
Okay, and now let's go. Okay.
Watch out!
Cork robbed. It has a significant range, I remember.
Your orders, sir.
So you need. Either I could try to run just through here, we don't need to destroy it. We'll get into the firefight. That would take time. Yeah, I guess I will just everyone run here. And we will try to run past him. Yeah, he's just standing there. We can just storm the entrance. Yeah.
Yes.
I mean, there are bigger rooms where the grenade launcher could come useful, but get the shotgun.
Ready, sir?
And yeah, you definitely need the shotgun.
And what is it?
Just walk over there.
That's it.
Okay, everyone is ready.
What is it?
I told you. Oh, you haven't yet finished the action.
Awaiting further orders.
Okay, so now you have finished the action. Let's save. Okay, and let's go in then. Yeah, you successfully managed to sneak in. Next.
Ready, sir?
Okay, and we got in and we need to kill 6 transgenons. Alright. Well, how should we start it? Well, we are in this corner of the base, so we should go clockwise, so all around.
Look over there!
Okay, an unarmed Anglerfly.
Yes? Yes, sir.
More orders!
What
there
is
are
it?
Always Ready, more orders. Sir.
I copy. What is it?
Yes, sir.
He went down.
He went down.
Yep.
Your order, sir.
Okay, continue. No, not. Oh, wow, guys. So yeah, it seems like there is quite a difficulty change between the out and the indoor enemies, because for example the Karkrabd and the Fire Tick and whatever the Dead Bellow are not fitting in here in the base. So it seems like we only have humanoid enemies here, which doesn't seem that more difficult.
Now what?
Ready, sir.
I hear you.
Now what?
I did it!
Yes, you did it.
Your order, sir.
Here they come!
Okay, another Danglerfly. Oh no.
Yes.
More orders!
Ready, sir.
Now what?
I hear you.
Yes, sir.
I read you.
Yes? The path is blocked.
What is it? The path is blocked. Awaiting further
orders. Oh no,
orders.
It's not an arm. We actually have a rifle.
He's gone. The path is blocked.
Lorenz cannot get over there. Yes, those were the shotguns.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. No, don't get out. Okay.
The path is blocked.
Now what?
I read you.
Yes.
Okay, there is no one inside.
What is it?
Ready, sir?
Then let's get out here. What? Oh, there's a door here. I didn't saw. Yeah, in these long corridors, sniper rifle and the grenade launcher is useful. Porzina tool.
Well, what do we have here?
Okay, that's some more ammo with a laser pistol. Okay. Bye, Mover Man.
That's one less than to worry about.
Wow. Yeah, that's right.
Rest in peace.
Hostile eliminated.
Yes.
That's one less of them off. To worry about.
A good riddance.
Good riddance.
Look over there.
Okay, move that man.
Your order, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Ready, sir.
I hear you.
Your order, sir. I hear you.
What is it?
A copy.
More orders.
Yes, sir.
Oh wow,
it turned around and fired and hit Crispin.
Ready, sir?
What is it?
Seems like a laser rifle. A laser pistol. Although it was light blue color, it might be the upgraded one.
More orders!
Yes, sir.
More orders!
Ready, sir.
I copy. No possible line of fire, sir.
I hear you. He's gone.
I hear you.
What is it?
Okay, get rid of that guy. Okay, that was yellowish color. The first one seemed like blue, but that maybe just because it's a laser weapon.
I doubt that that's one less of them to worry about.
Okay.
Your orders, sir.
I hear you.
Your orders, sir.
I can reload.
What is it?
Ready, sir.
I made it.
Well, if you are ready, then go over there and
get it out. Now,
I did it.
Awaiting further
what
orders.
Now, sir?
I did it.
Also, we wanna hear Crispin. And Zunato, you will do that. You are our best medic.
Yes, what?
Sir. Oh, we can already see what it is. Yes, it's our advanced alien laser pistol. Even though, oh wow, I didn't even realize that I can do this. I don't actually need to run over an alien or something, a mutant, to check what it have. All I need to do is just order someone to run over there, and then we will be able to see what's on the ground there. Wow, I didn't even realize that. So yeah, I did realize it was a little bit different. That's because that's an advanced alien laser pistol, not the general one. Okay.
Yes.
What is it? I made it.
Yes, you made it.
I made it.
Now here, Crispin.
That's it.
That's it. Why didn't even remember that I gave Zunato a shotgun? Why did I do that? A P90 is good enough. Huh. Yeah, I didn't even remember that I did that. Alright. Okay.
Awaiting further orders.
Yes, sir.
Alright, let's continue. Oh, I didn't even check that there is a back thingy here. Okay, there's nothing inside here.
There's one.
Oh, there's a danglerfly with a rifle.
Ready, sir.
More orders!
What is it? The path is blocked.
Your orders, sir.
Standing by. No route to destination.
I hear you.
What is it? Rest in peace.
Okay. I hear you.
So yeah, that wasn't good, because only the forward element was in firing range with the rest of the guys back. So that wasn't optimal.
Ready, sir.
Yes, sir.
More orders!
What now, sir?
That's it!
Let's heal.
I made it!
You can reload.
Your orders, sir.
You can reload.
More orders!
You heal? Yeah.
Awaiting further
I made it!
Yeah, you made it.
Awaiting further orders.
Ready, sir. Okay. Now, get over there. So yeah, that's why it's so bad to have different speed, because the guys will be in a what is this, column? Yeah. I mean, they will still will be in column if they have the same speed, because they just cannot fit. Two men can fit beside each other here. But it worsens if there is speed difference.
I need it. Further
orders. Your orders, sir.
I need it. Further orders, sir.
I need it. Further orders.
So that's why I wait every big turn. But yeah, I mean, that's a long corridor. If I would really want to micromanage this, every time we have a big corridor like this, I could switch to the sniper rifle and the grenade launcher. Okay, we were here already, there's a dangly fly. I think we were walking over here, but I didn't check this door here. Okay, so yeah, we were here before. I can see the dead bodies, but I didn't see the interior of the base. I just walked around. So let's cut in here and go over here.
There's one.
Okay, there's dangly fly. Unarmed.
Yes, sir.
Now what?
I hear you.
Yes, sir.
You can start firing.
I copy. No route to destination.
Yes.
I read you.
What is it? The path is blocked.
What is it?
What is it?
I've lost sight of him.
Yes, sir.
Let's bang up here. It must come out if it went in there. I could even toss some grenades over there.
Awaiting further orders, sir.
Awaiting further orders.
Oh, but you have a pitiful range.
I hear you.
Wisping. you have a grenade launcher. That will be the trick here.
Awaiting further orders.
Ready, sir.
Yes.
Yeah.
I did it!
What now, sir?
Well, I cannot see if he's dead or not. Let's continue advance.
I hear you.
Fire again. Oh yeah, that got him. There's a green there. Fire again. Only way to be sure. Enemy was critical hit for 1200. Oh yeah, that's dead. That's real dead. Okay, reload. Yep. Okay, we got them. Yes, you did it. Alright, let's save this. We can overwrite number 8 save. And let's end this mission. Two soldiers were wounded, but no sickbay, one soldier reached new level. We killed 4 danglerfly. Oh, and 2 morale men. Oh, it was G3, the one of the rifles, so that's crap. Yeah, there was 2 advanced laser pistols, but they were only powered by energy cell, not pirate cell. And FN4, crappy. Okay, and it's Ia who got a new level. Let's check what I have wrote about him. I have intelligence 4 times. Okay. Yeah, awful intelligence, awful perfection. Okay, so you go for intelligence. Okay, and now we have captured this base too, which is in Managua. And we did knew that it was Managua because of the mission. This is a new mission available in Managua. But I still don't know where Managua is, so I'm gonna Google it. Managua? Oh, it's in Nicaragua. It's the capital city of Nicaragua. I see. And I have the map up now, so that I can better understand. Yeah, I can see on the map, yeah. I was not that wrong, El Salvador is here. This is Nicaragua here. Like that, and then this is Costa Rica and that's Panama. So yeah, that's Nicaragua, El Salvador is here, Honduras is here. Okay. Alright, not that bad. I wasn't very far. Okay, so now we have 3 military bases here. All 3 of them operational. So I gonna change one. Once again, question is to change it to what? So far I have been researching with great speed. This auto speed doesn't do much. Once I finish with the lime tower, I can switch over to the transgaran theory, but then there will be just more auto speed to do. Meanwhile, on development, there is not that much interesting either. Although there is the aircraft range and the aircraft maneuverability, and yeah, sooner or later I will need to make more development bases at the expense of research bases. And yeah, this here really doesn't do anything. All of the fighter activities over here in this front. However, yeah, if I dismantle this base into a research or development base, then this will be open. Here, yeah, obviously the Mexico City base is in the back, so this should be changed. The question is then, yeah, change to what? Once I got the range and the maneuverability, there will be once again not that much stuff I want to do. Well, I would like to have alien, basic alien armor. We need that so that we can get on with the sun armor to make at least one of these. But it takes way too much time. Yeah, I know it's a catch 22. Without making more development bases, it makes too much time to build them, build the stuff, which makes me not want to put resources into development, which makes it even harder on the long term to make things, because the more advanced stuff will make more time to build, so we will need more development bases. But yeah, the range and the maneuverability is one thing I wanna do. I mean, once I make second development base, that will double my speed compared to one. So that should halve the speed, half the time required to do stuff. I mean, in theory, I don't exactly know if it was like that, it should be. Yeah, but there is not really that much I wanna do here. I want the range and want the maneuverability. And want the armor once it's possible. Yeah, the sun armor? No, I don't need the sun armor either. It will be just a requirement to get to the sky armor. Which I will very much like to have. The sun armor I don't exactly really need, because it's anti-projectile, anti-human weapon, so that's actually not useful for our use against the aliens. And the light armor and light helmet is really, you know, why would I mean, yeah, I have the combat armor, yes, that's heavy, 10 kilogram, but we can wear it. So why would I want these? Yeah, at least with the alien armor, it's a requirement for the stun armor to have at least one. So... But the light armor and helmet is useless. I don't see how it will be of any use. Okay, yeah, let's make a second engineering base so that I can get the aircraft things ready. Let's change some Mexico City into engineering. So yeah, right now I have all the US cities into research, and I have Churchill and Mexico City in production, and I have the frontier, four bases of the frontier be military base. Okay, and now I can send the team over here. Yeah, oh yeah, I just captured this base, so I have to spend a little time so that it registers properly. So yeah, we discovered a catch, and we captured Managua, and the chopper just arrived back to the base. Okay. Anything new here? I mean, no. So let's see. If we got anything new here. Well, we got the two advanced laser pistol, and we have from earlier the power cell. Let's have double the capacity, the energy cell. But we cannot use this yet. And the rifles, we have a shit ton of these crappy rifles. And we have now two PSG heavy sniper rifles, not very useful. Ooh! And we got the Super Striker, which is another grenade launcher, but have 12 capacity. Super Striker. Yeah, I think this is the one from Terminator 2. Yeah, that looks pretty much it. Yeah, this is like a, you know, M79. I think this is like a Vietnam era grenade launcher. Very old. I think this is, yeah, a more modern version. It has lower range, but it has burst fire. Fascinating. In the other section, we just have more flamethrowers. Ooh, and we got a new armor. We found a heavy armor. 20 kilograms. Wow. Yeah, we didn't make it, we just found it. Heavy armor. 20 kilograms. So yeah, this is 5, this is 10, this is 20. But have 75% soft protection. Basically, you know, normal bullets are tickling it. Even the armor piercing is, you know, half the damage is negated. Yeah, but then we can see that against the alien weapons, it's not that good. Laser is only 25% defended, so... Plasma 20, warp 25, that's actually bad. Exception, that the psi damage, I think. Heal. Yeah, it even have a protection against healing. Yeah, so the other weapons doesn't. So it actually depends against healing. Yeah, because it's so cumbersome to have this armor and it covers the body. It's actually difficult, it makes it difficult to heal the person wearing it. So yeah, it actually negates healing. So the medkit only deals 80% of the healing. Of, I think it deals 100 healing. Yeah, there. Minus 100 damage. So, for someone who is wearing the heavy armor, it will only heal 80. Yeah, and against the alien weapons, it's not very good. And yeah, as you can see, the clothing actually defends 70% against the plasma. Not the plasma, the warp damage. The light armor 55%. The combat armor 35%, the heavy armor is only defending 25% against the warp attack. Let's see, laser. Huh. So yeah, the light armor deals no defense against the enemy alien attacks. The combat armor is having 20%. Then that plus 5% is not very good. So it barely gives additional defense against laser. Against plasma though, it have double the protection of the combat armor. It only defends 10%, this is 20%, but still that's not a lot. Interesting, it have 10% defense against exception damage, so... So the heavy armor defense against psi attacks a very little bit. Because it's difficult to get into the mind of someone who is wearing such a heavy armor. Maybe the helmet, yeah. So, overall, it's not a good trade-off. The combat armor is a good trade-off against the light armor. It's a fair trade-off against the light armor, but then the heavy armor is not. It's not worth it. Against the alien weapons, against the human weapons, it is worth it. I mean, it's soft projectiles deals basically no damage. had double the protection against the semi-armor piercing and almost 5 times the protection against the armor piercing. So yeah, this is, you know, a tank against projectiles and the burn damage. But against the alien laser and plasma weapons and warp weapons, it's not good. So yeah, this is like the anti-mutants weapon. We can have this, you know, against mutants, but not very good against the aliens. And I also think I remember that you cannot run in a heavy armor. But that might be once again just something from the later games. Anyhow. So yeah, that's what we got. Let's see. Anyone? Iya got a new level up, right? But he still cannot get on any training. But yeah, I did get level 6 everyone. Dinato is 7, Shavat is 8, Jim is 7, Malcolm 10, Richard 6, John 9, August 6, Gene is still just 5, and Matre is 6, and Brian is 9. Okay. Okay, so no one can go on training. Okay, but yeah, there is that mission there, but before that I'm gonna consult with the glossary here. So we have here the heavy armor. This armor, which is very heavy and bulky, gives the greatest protection against penetrating projectiles, yet it also allows you to use special gyro-stabilized weapons. Further, it includes an advanced combat helmet for maximum body protection. The lack of mobility is compensated by a special system of detectors. Huh. I have no idea of what detectors is speaking of. Sensors. And it's interesting use of special gyro stabilized weapons. We have no such thing yet. Okay. And in the equipment we can see the advanced laser, alien laser pistol. This version of the alien laser pistol uses enhanced energy cells, allowing it to stay in action for longer periods without reloading. In other respects it's quite similar to its counterpart. No! No, goddamn it, description. No, that's not the case. No. No. As we have seen before, the advanced pistol and gun can come with the basic energy cell. It doesn't mean that it have to use the power cell. Once again, the description is wrong. And I'm pretty sure that you can use the advanced alien power cell with the default laser weapons too. It just means it has higher capacity. The advanced alien laser pistol is, you know, being actually a better weapon, upgraded weapon than the one. And you can see it here too. So yeah, 35 is the base damage. And this is 50. And have higher ranges too, all across the board. But the laser beam itself is deals more damage. Yeah. Yeah. The aimed rate of fire didn't improve, but the burst fire, yes, from 2.5 to 3.3. So it now have over 166 damage per second. Yeah. Still, I don't really see the use of this. This is clearly just a self-defense weapon. Because yeah, the pistols can deal much higher damage at short ranges. Actually, you know, according to this data here, the pistols are dealing the most damage out of all weapons in close range, maybe they're not the shotguns. However, yeah, what you know, it doesn't really tell us is the accuracy. So we do see that the pistols have the lowest range, but it's not obvious at once that this means that they are having lower accuracy too. So their theoretical damage is the highest of all weapons, but that's if you know all around hit. So yeah. So yeah, with you know, for example, the USP 9, 360 damage per second, even if it just soaked. Well, this is halfway there, and this laser damage, which is much less resisted than the soft. So yeah, this could be superior to the USP 9, depending on the opponent. But yeah, then we have the 5.7 tactical, which is the semi, full-on armor piercing. Yeah, this deals 340 damage with armor piercing. I think that's better than this. But yeah, depends on what enemy we are facing. Okay. And the other new weapon we got is the Super Striker. This weapon, the basic handheld grenade launcher, allows for the close to medium range engagement of groups of soft and lightly armored targets. It's especially effective in burst mode. However, that advantage is offset by the rate of the ammunition and the low rate of fire, as well as the extra friendly fire dangers involved when using an explosive weapon at such short range. The later problem is exacerbated by the Super Strike's poor accuracy. So yeah, the weapon is a bit heavier than the grenade launcher, but it makes up with the ammunition. So yeah, the ammunition is a bit heavier, however with 12 round capacity, while the grenade launcher, the M79, is 6. So yeah, the Super Striker is the better weapon, immediately, just by the capacity, double the capacity. So that's very good. Yeah, but we do see that the M79 have better range, 45. So that's quite important, the range. 45 is a big range, bigger than the rifle. The damage, both of them deal semi-armor piercing. Wow, so yeah, in aim mode, the M79 have higher range and more damage. 162 per second. Super Striker is only dealing 100. Because both the individual round damage is lower and have slightly less rate of fire. So yeah, at aim mode, the M79 is actually better, even though it has half the capacity, have longer range and more damage. Yeah, but then the Super Striker have burst fire mode. Oh, it has very low range. Effective range is 5 meters, but it have 4 rounds per second, that's 800 damage per second. Oh wow, and 4 rounds per second does mean that it runs out of ammunition in that in 3 seconds. However, it doesn't need to fire for 3 seconds with that amount of damage. So yeah, I think this is a situation where both weapon is viable in different situations. The M79 is the overall better weapon because of the range. Range and higher damage. But the Super Strike have the short range burst fire ability. Yeah. So yeah, that's up to experimentation to find out which is the better, but I I tend to go with the better range. It means better accuracy too. And yeah, it has higher damage. So what if it has 6 round capacity? 3 seconds is not the end of the world of reload speed. Okay. Okay. So I'm switching this to production, which should increase the speed of this. Yeah, one day to finish. Okay, and I need to send a team from Havana to this alien craft. And I have Richard available here, level 6. Question is, do I wanna leave someone from here for Richard? I guess not. I guess I can just go with this team. Yeah, interesting that I decided to give Zinatula a shotgun. I guess there is not much else I can carry. But yeah, the P90 would be nice too. Short range with the armor piercing. This deals catastrophically high damage, but doesn't really have that range. But that burst fire, there is not that much difference. Yeah, I guess I can go with this team. So yeah, one question here is, with Crispin, do I bring Super Strike or do I bring the grenade launcher? I am pretty sure I will bring the grenade launcher, because I do not trust, you know, grenade launching in the UFO. So we will likely use it in the getting into the UFO section, at which the better range, higher range and better damage is what we need. So yeah, let's go with this team. Do I want someone to bring the heavy armor? Not really. Like, it doesn't give me that much protection. Although Zinatul, who's already slow and have a lot of excess capacity, could bring it. So let's see, if I drop all of this, what happens if I give you this? Ooh, wow. So this is the heavy armor. Ah, even the inventory, the backpack here changes, and it also drops the helmet, because this have... Oh yeah, but that one thing I didn't consider, that this have a built-in helmet. Oh wow, I didn't consider that, that's huge mistake. Yeah, I was just comparing the combat armor, but this have armor and helmet in together. So this is not 10 kg, this is 12 actually. If we calculate this, and then it have actually 75% soft damage protection, the same as this, and then universal is 40%. This is just a bit more, but yeah, again, armor piercing is dosho. This is 15%, this is 45, so that's much better. And this doesn't help with anything else. So yeah, with the helmet on, the projectile protection does The difference in projectile protection does drop is the same in soft. Only have significantly more protection in hard. And then Arcane's laser damage is almost the same. So yeah, and this is 12 kg. This is still almost the double of that weight. Still, we have it, let's use it, right? And it's interesting, even the backpack changes into this metal thingy here, metallic backpack. And yeah, what the? Something is not right here. With the combat armor, it says that 24 kg the load, and it's 56%. If I give the heavy armor, it becomes 34 kg, but the load becomes 53%. So something is bugged out here. Some calculation is not going well here. Yeah, the load percentage goes down. Oh, wait. What if... I need to investigate this more. Yeah, the load percentage goes down. Which I think might be because there is something counteracting the weight here. Huh. So that's tricky, even though it's have a heavier weight, the load goes down. So yeah, what I think is that it have like servos in it, that it's like a power armor. That's actually, you know, have distributing the weight and helps moving the arms and legs. Because yeah, that's interesting. That makes this actually a better armor than the combat armor. Well, you still cannot run in it, that's what I remember. But yeah, that means that this is actually something for someone who cannot wear the combat armor easily. Someone who is having trouble carrying stuff around. Yeah, so Zinatul is the one who will be in the front. So he is likely to be having the most attack on him. So I'm still considering that little bit more laser and plasma protection could come into play. However, so yeah, Zinatul is the slowest guy, so even if I try to micromanage, he still might need to run. So I'm not gonna give him the heavy armor. I'm gonna give the heavy armor to Crispin, I think. Yeah. Okay, so he can bring some extra ammunition. There. Okay. And then using that tool. Do I wanna bring Neostad? I can. Grenades and some reload. Okay, so that's fascinating. Hmm. So yeah, even though it's heavy, it's actually less heavy than the combat armor. I will need some time to have my head wrap around that, but okay. Okay, move out, team. And here I am still chasing after that UFO, with not much chance to get it. Here some soldiers finished training, that's not Richard, he finished it beforehand. Not very finished training and have now nothing to do. Okay. Okay, and we have the secret of slime to autospeed. Okay. These creatures, commonly called slime throwers, are derived from earthworms, wow. Internally they are quite simple, being little more than a tube of muscle and a few oversized simply organs. They suffer only minimal damage from warp weapons or hard bullets. They are also impervious to flame, given that they are covered in thick, protective mucus. However, they are particularly vulnerable to plasma, soft bullets and explosions, which are extremely damaging to softer targets. Okay, we can check that in the... we can double check that in that cluster here, because we know we cannot trust the description. So yeah, it have a 24 meter range attack with 150 damage. Oh, interesting. So the plankton is actually much more dangerous than the slime thrower, even though the plankton appeared earlier. It have much higher range, double almost the range, and double the damage. Huh. The plankton is the more dangerous one. It also have good resistance. Slime thrower though, Yeah, still have 0% soft but have 40 and 80% resistance against armor piercing. And plankton is not protected against burn, meanwhile the slime thrower is. And have defense against laser too. Although the plankton have higher defense against laser. But yeah, have no defense against plasma. But have very high defense against warp. Okay. With this, we have the Transgenon theory available. Okay, so we have a new description here now. Well, we think we have enough information on the individual Transgenon to try and draw some more general conclusions. There are some interesting overall similarities we would like to explore which could really pay off in the long run. Yeah, it's one of the necessities for the biomass growth theory. But yeah, so we have all the necessary research, but of the recommended booster research we only have the flopper. Yeah, there is a ton of them left here. Let's see how long it would take now. It would take 2 days, 12 hours. So now is the question, is do I go on with this? Or do the other auto speeds that I can do? Yeah, if I do this in this order, doing this first, then I will not get the benefit from doing those researches. So I think it goes down to the urgency. Do we need this Transgenon theory right now? No, we don't. So until we get the biomass sample, we have no need for this. But so here it is. My head already starts to hurt a little bit for thinking way too hard on this. So for the biomass growth theory, we need that theory that we can do now, and we need the biomass analysis. For the biomass analysis, we need a sample of the biomass. So, for that we need a mission on the biomass. So, what we want here is to finish with this theory by the time we get the sample of biomass. So we want to finish this theory by the time we got the sample of biomass, because then we can do the biomass analysis. And then we have both of these, and then we can do this. So we can delay this now, but not delay it until we have a mission on the biomass. Because by the time we coming back with the sampler, we will need this to be finished, so that we can immediately start with this research. And then we can immediately start with this research. Okay, so yeah, we can delay it now, but I have to time it and switch over to it anytime it seems it gets close to have a mission on the biomass. Okay, so yeah, we can wait. So what else would I like to do? We have the energy cell principle to make energy cells, that no need, and the psi weapon operation to be able to use psi weapons. We can finish it in 23 hours. Not really important. The psi stinger is fascinating, you can paralyze enemies with it. But it's an extremely short range, so why would I paralyze the enemy if at the same range I can just eliminate them with the shotgun? So yeah, I think I will go with these researchers. So yeah, the balloon fish. We don't have a live balloon fish, of course, so it's 9 hours. And the spore blower, that's 9 hours too. So yeah, I tried to remember at which order this came. I think it was Spore Blower, Balloon Fish, and Crystallis and Gobber, and maybe Dead Bellow, Carcrab, then Fire Tick. So yeah, these are 9 hours. The Crystallis is 13 hours, the Gobber 13 hours, the Dead Bellow 19 hours, Carcrab 13 hours. Fire Tick 19 hours. Okay, so yeah, even though we don't have the live specimens here, let's do this. I think we cannot get the live specimens of these because they just explode. It's still funny there is the option here. Okay, so we do have a live car club, but we don't have a live fire tick. So maybe that's why it takes longer, yeah. That bellow, yeah, we don't have a live that bellow either. Ah, so here I think we can see it's 6 hour difference in having the live or not live one, assuming that these are the same time wise. So yeah, that does matter. And yeah, it's, you know, we assume, you know, just calculate with 6 hour. Probably not 6 hour. Because yeah, I'm thinking of the transgenant theory. Now it would take 2 day 12 hours, and how many booster research we have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Maybe if, you know, each of them reduces research time with 1 hour, it would still take like 1/3 of this research time. So yeah, I do think it's beneficial to do the auto speed first, so that this will take less time. And we don't have immediate use of this, as far as I can see. I just have to time it for this to be finished by the time we are coming back with the sample of biomass. But that doesn't seem like in the close future. We are still far away from the biomass. Well, our advancement toward the Europe is pretty much stuck. I don't know why. Well, yeah, because there is this Arctic Ocean here, makes it more difficult to advance, and there is long distances over here between the bases. But yeah, I still wanna cross over to Europe, the biomass is very threatening. Although, you know, in one hand it's very threatening, on the other hand it's also good because we really want a sample of biomass. So yeah. So, we can wait with the Transgenon theory for now. So let's do the spore blower. 9 hours. Okay, and yeah, we can see here the range. The aircraft turned around, it cannot intercept the planter. They run out of range, sadly. And we... Okay, so yeah, this self-defense mission here that we have been ignoring for how many days, I don't know, for a long time, has been resolved automatically by the Council of Earth troops. Our troops have returned from the mission near Los Angeles. They have succeeded. Very good. So we don't need to do it. And we are almost at the UFO here, so let's save. Save number 9. Let's do it. And we are here.
Ready, sir.
So now we can see the heavy armor.
I hear you.
I hear you. Okay. Cool.
More orders!
There are always more orders.
There's an alien!
Okay, wow. So that's Reticulan with a plasma gun and a shun shield. And of course I once again jumped the space bar, which caused not only the animation to jump, but also we missed precious time with that.
Your orders, sir.
More orders!
At least with it aiming Xenator, it not will be, you know, the grenades, the plasma grenades will not impact the group. But that's good.
What is it?
Wow.
Your orders, sir. I just cannot see him.
What do you mean you cannot see him?
Now what?
What is it?
You don't have a direct line of sight, but you have grenades.
Your orders, sir.
Your orders, sir. Well, run somewhere from where you can see him.
I copy.
What is it? He's gone.
Okay, start firing. Ooh, wow! That plasma grenade missed Xenator with a lot. That impacted over there, not at Xenator. Okay, let's see. Okay, so I think that wasn't a sun shield. Oh, no, it wasn't a sky shield. I saw a blue impact on Reticulan earlier. This blue impact. But okay, so that was a sun shield, not a sky shield. But with that I already spoiled the next shield color and next shield upgrade we will see, but that's okay. So yeah, on impact it have a blue coloring, but it's still a sun shield. Okay, that was the grenade of Crispin arriving. Okay, so we got lucky there. The plasma gun could have messed up us, but luckily we got him. Yeah, the grenade launcher is still smoking.
Oh, we're getting further orders.
What less of him to worry about?
Yes,
yeah.
I read you. I hear you.
Now what?
Okay, so where is the UFO over there?
Ready, sir?
He's gone!
Ready, sir?
Walk over there.
Damn! I'm hit!
Oh!
More orders!
Oh, Xenator did got hit.
Your orders, sir.
didn't notice that. Well,
more
luckily,
orders.
You can hear yourself.
That's it.
Ready, sir?
That's it.
Oh wow, you guys.
Your orders, sir.
Really
should
not orders.
Run forward that much. This is not where you actually need to run forward. Oh.
Your orders, sir.
Like that.
Now what?
Yes, sir.
Here comes a grey.
Okay, that's at least a gun.
Your orders, sir.
Now
I
what?
I hear you.
More orders!
I hear you.
Your orders, sir.
Standing by.
Yes?
Standing by.
What is it?
Awaiting further orders.
Ready, sir.
Okay. Let's try to hit Sebastian, but that's... And that was Crispin. I like the grenade launcher.
Yes.
Yeah, but you, Crispin, you should reload. Now we have the capacity to reload. You guys can reload too. Hmm. Okay.
I got
it. Oh, there's another one. We didn't saw before. That's a side blaster. It's hit here. Doesn't seem like he's affected. Here you need to stop what you are doing and run behind the cover of the bus.
Yes, sir.
More orders.
I hear you.
Yes, sir.
I read you.
Yes, he's gone.
What is it?
Now
yes.
What?
Unable to hit him now.
Too far away.
What now, sir?
I copy.
Your orders, sir.
More orders.
Yes, sir.
What is it?
I hear you.
I hear you.
Okay. That was a grenade launch.
Awaiting further orders.
Okay. So yeah, you can see how little damage the Psy weapon actually does. Psy blaster. It hit here for minimal damage. Oops, I didn't want
your orders,
to say.
Sir.
Okay, everyone. Get here, regroup.
Incoming fire.
What is it? No way to get there.
What is it?
Now we can reload.
I hear you.
That's it.
Standing by.
Now what?
I'm ready for further orders.
What is it?
Awaiting further orders.
That's it.
I did it.
Okay.
I did it.
Okay, and now...
Your orders, sir.
Everyone walk over here. This map is so slow.
What is it?
Run, Zenator.
Ready, sir?
Yes.
You can't change the shotgun.
Yes, sir.
You can change the shotgun too. You
what can is reload. It?
Oh, reload and doctor is changed the shotgun too.
That's it.
I did it.
Awaiting further orders.
Right.
I copy.
You can reload too. Can come in with full magazines.
What now, sir?
I'm ready for further orders.
Now save number 10. And just go into the next level. Hopefully it will not crash. Seems like it's crashing. I hope you had fun. See you next time. Bye bye.